Good morning, DDO Wiki Twitch viewers. I am your DDO Wiki sysop and administrator and bureaucrat and steward and all those awesome things, ShoeMaker, technical 13. And we've got an exciting day today. Good morning, Azender. So, last night, I got an email from Zeebo, our host for the DDOwiki site. And the wiki has been upgraded from version 1.19 to version 1.23, which is a pretty big jump. Good morning, Edward. With a silent T. I remember. I read and notice those things. So yeah, we upgraded from 1.19 to 1.23, the latest LTS version. So let's take a look at what that is. You can see the wiki. I put a big banner up on the top of the page there. I left the banner up overnight because and I'm going to leave it up for a few more days because the upgrade is new and there are some things that may not be working like they used to or like you expect them to. If you find one of these things that isn't working like it used to or like you expect it to, and it isn't in our known issues list, get in touch with me somehow. You can see that you can either click on the link here to go to the IRC chat channel. You can go directly to my user talk page, or you can send me an email through the wiki. This banner right here is on every single page on the wiki right now, so no matter where you navigate to, you'll see that banner. It's part of the site notice. It will be everywhere. I've made a post on the forum for it. Let me hide the Twitch chat and that for a minute. Well, I can leave my picture up, I guess. Yep, I made a post up on it for the wiki. This is where our list of improvements and known issues is. Take a chance to read through there. You can also PM me on the forum or respond directly to this message, and I will, I'm gonna subscribe to this thread right now on this DDO Wiki account. I actually made a new DDO stream user for the stream here. Instant notification, add. Right, so looks like there's already been a comment on there. Just a message of praise, and like I said, those would be addressed as quickly as is reasonable. So, thank you for your word of praise. That's been addressed. I've also put up a post on the forums about this stream, where I will be keeping a log of all of our streams here with links to them. And then I will also be posting the actual episodes in the feed. And today's will go up down at the bottom there, episode 6. So today is episode 6. Close those up for now. Pop over to IRC for a minute, make sure nobody's reporting a bug. So what does this mean exactly? Actually, let me bring that back up in the forums. Let's go over that list a little bit. Some improvements that you'll notice is that the system will now auto-confirm Users, after 50 edits in 10 days, you no longer need to wait for an administrator or another VIP to notice that you have 100 edits to give you the permission. The system automatically does it, and you will be able to skip capture with that. Let me open that up in a new tab. And this page right here isn't accurate yet. So to get the accurate version, we go to list group rights, and I typed it in wrong. It's something like list groups rights or something like that. List group rights. Thought that's what I typed. Anyway, so you'll see that auto confirmed are allowed to edit semi-protected pages, and they have skip captcha, so you don't have to wait for DDOwiki VIP for that anymore. Users get a whole bunch of permissions here. Most of them are the same as what they were. If one of those is missing that was there and you need it for some reason, let me know. DDOwiki VIPs can now move files, which means you can rename files. And the big thing here is that you also get used to the right API, which means that you'll be able to use some awesome new tools. We'll get into that in a little bit. You'll also see that DDOwiki VIPs can add people to VIP. The next tier up, super user, can add people to VIP and super user and remove VIPs. Basically, every level can add people to their own level and remove people from lower levels. That's kind of on a probational thing right now. We'll get to that in a minute too, which is right here. If it's found that that's being abused, people are promoting or demoting people without just cause, that privilege will be removed. You'll note that we had like 9 skins before. We're down to the default 4. Many of the older and outdated skins have been deprecated and are no longer available, such as Elliot Cable's True Glass skin that a few people were still using. If you have a need for one of those removed skins, good morning, Skunk. If you have a need for one of those removed skins, please get in touch with me, and I will figure out how to get it set up best for you. If it's a skin that a lot of people request, I will have Zevo reinstall it. If it's one of the ones that's deprecated and won't work anymore, it may take a while for that to happen. I might need to go through and rebuild the skin. And that's okay too. If I have to go in and make changes to the skin so that it will work with the new update, that's what I'll do. But we can get stuff set up for you one way or another. I already mentioned that moving files has been fixed, mostly. There may still be some files that you can't rename or move. Usually these are files that were on the old EnterWiki system, and the files themselves were copied over, but the database entries for them were not. So the wiki doesn't know they exist, even though they pop up. It finds the files, but they're not in the database, so it doesn't know what to do with them. If you find one of those, let me know about it, and I will take care of it appropriately. Or let one of the other administrators know about it, and they will take care of it appropriately. DDOwiki and above now have write API access, which I was talking about a minute ago. This allows us to import tools such as Wicked and Twinkle from Wikipedia, with some modifications, of course. It also means that a multitude of other useful tools that I've been working on and I end up getting stalled on because people didn't have write API, I will be able to finish. So you'll be able to click a button and, update a page, or click a button and send a default email. If you're an administrator and you see that somebody, has been inactive for a while and you go to their page and stuff, you'll be able to click a button that sends an email saying, "Hey, we miss you, come back." And then one of the other skin things is that the horrible WP Touch mobile skin that nobody liked is gone. So now you can browse more freely on your mobile device or tablet without that skin causing you all kinds of grief. You'll be using the default vector skin for that, and there'll be no more redirecting to the m. version, the mobile version of the website. So your custom JavaScript should work on your device if it supports them. Let's turn that back on because I can't see all of what he said. Came in a bit late as you were talking about user group level, so I may have missed this, but is there a way to find out what level we are in? Absolutely. Let me finish with the known issues here. It's a known issue that system administrators are unable to create protect pages, which means that if a page title doesn't have any content on it, we can't protect that title to prevent people from creating a page for, shit or something like that. Zeebo already knows about it and it will be fixed. It just hasn't gotten to it yet. I'll note that some of the JavaScript gadgets and user scripts may not work. They may be broken because of the way that the API has changed from version 1.19, and some of the global scripts. JavaScript global variables have been modified and changed the way that they're handled. So if you find a script that isn't working or a gadget that isn't working, please report it to me, either by commenting on the thread, sending a PM, visiting me in IRC, leaving a message on my talk page, or sending me an email. My email address, if you can either click on any of the links to use special email user technical underscore 13 on the wiki. There's all kinds of email links to me on the wiki that uses the system, or you can send it directly to either my technical 13 at yahoo.com or my legend.of.the.red.dragon at gmail.com, whichever one works for you. Some people don't like sending things to Yahoo because it rejects them because of their current DMARC policy. But yeah, you can use my Legend of the Red Dragon, all separated by dots, at Gmail as well. The account creation welcome screen will need to be updated, which if you already have an account, it won't be an issue for you. But if you're creating an account, there may be a little bit of a inconsistency there. Things may not be working right. They may be a little bit broken. So, Mayquist asked how to find which what your group what groups you are in. So, if you go to your preferences at the top of the page here, you will get a your preference page. It'll have your username, your user ID number, and it will tell you what groups you are in. Auto confirm user, DDOwiki VIP, and user. You're also in a group that's called Star. It's an all-encompassing. It's for anybody that visits Wiki, even IP editors. But it's not listed because it's just everybody. So it'll tell you how many edits you have that haven't been deleted. It'll tell you when you registered, what your real name is, allow you to change your password. You can set all your preferences here. Everybody has an email link and their signature that if you don't have your email set up, it won't show up. MediaWiki has added a few new email options with 1.23. If you go to appearance, you'll see that we only have these four skins right now. If you need another skin, let us know. I'm aware that some people like the skin with this toolbar over on the right side. I am going to see what I can do about creating one and getting it back up there. You'll note that your threshold for stub links is disabled. If you want to work on stubs, you should probably turn that back on. I would recommend 500 bytes. Show hidden categories is entirely up to you. Let's see here. Editing. Nothing's really changed there. A couple new options, I guess. Appearance. Nothing's changed there. Watch list. Nothing's really changed there. Not that anybody uses their watch list on this wiki. Search options. Default search. Search is there. And then gadgets. We have our... We don't really have a watch list on this account, but you can turn that on, I guess. You'll see that there's a section of tools here. You can have all of your watch list pages show up in bold and recent changes. When you load the main page, you can have the cursor focus in the search bar. You can open external links in a new tab or window. The number of members for each special page is on special pages. I don't think that one is on by default. Edit tools is an enhanced edit tool section at the bottom of the page. We have email links that will show links to special email user for anything using template user or signatures. If the user has emailed enabled, if you don't, it doesn't show the link. And then we have this new one that I put up last night called PP Indicators. It's a gadget that will show a die icon next to your username and the toolbar. PP toolbar, people are like, what is that? It just simply means this toolbar up top here. This is the PP toolbar that represents the page protection level for the page. So if we navigate back to the home page, you'll see it's got a little red die icon up here that says it's full protection enabled when you mouse over it. And you can actually click on that. And it will take you to the appropriate section of our protection policy page. A red die is a page with full edit and move protection that can only be edited and moved by an administrator. If you are not an admin and need assistance getting a fully protected page edited or moved, you should put in a request on the talk page of the page that you need edited with a fully detailed description of what you want changed or where you want it moved and why. And an administrator should either make the edit for you, ask for clarification, or deny the request. So if we wanted to make an edit to, you can see all the different dye here. You've got black, red, red, blue, red, purple, blue, red, blue, blue, purple, red, purple, blue, and there's actually a purple, just a regular purple for unprotected pages, which isn't up there yet. More dye colors may be added in the future. I'm thinking of adding a pink lock and a light blue lock, which are just create protection, or a pink lock for I don't know yet. Maybe a light blue for create protection, and then a pink lock for maybe file protection or something. Or I may take the existing ones and just add a pink element to the top, make the 20 on the top be pink for files. I haven't really decided yet on all that. But when you mouse over them, it will tell you what the protection level is. If you want to see examples of each one, what they look like in action, dropped a little spot of coffee on my keyboard. You'll see that recent changes has changed a little bit. They've added a legend here. You can just collapse that and it will remember it for the majority of it. You can see I did a lot of work on the page protection thing there yesterday. So we need to see more edits. We're at 75 right now. Let's go up to 100. Alright, so scroll down at the bottom now with it at 100. Ah, there we go. So you can see I have a page that's just in my user space called Protection Tests, which is where I was doing my testing for it. So if we open up one of each of these, I can actually edit this page. You'll see that media wiki pages. Yeah, it's going to take a minute for it to load. Let's check IRC for a minute. No new bugs there. Alright, so this is this page is a media wiki namespace page. You'll see it's got a black die. Mouse over it says user interface page. Fully protected is the red die that we already saw. You can see a red blue die there. That means that it's full semi protection, which means full edit semi move, which means that anybody can move it, but only an administrator can edit. We got a red purple here, which means it's full edit protection only. Anybody can move it. We got a blue red here, which means that any auto-confirmed editor can edit it, but only an administrator can move it. Solid blue is anybody that's auto-confirmed can move or edit. Blue-purple means that only auto-confirmed people can edit it, but anybody can move it. And then purple-red is full move protection, which means that anybody can edit it, but only an administrator can move it. And we have purple-blue, which means that auto-confirmed is required to move it. And then the final one is just a purple die, which means that the page is not protected, which they're all links to their respective sections, black, red, blue, and the purple one just takes you to the page. There has been some discussion about getting rid of the purple die by default so that if the page isn't protected, there's no icon. And I would love to get community feedback on whether or not you think that having a purple die is necessary. Like that right there. Should every page have a die? Or should only protected pages have a die? Because that's very easy to get rid of. If people think that that's what it should be. So we can actually get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of that. Because the with script thing here that I'm deleting, the using script, was before I actually enabled it as a default gadget. The only way to get to it was to click on the using scripts and have it load with the script. Gonna show changes. Oh, looks like I missed one. And then show preview. There we go, that looks good. Within a day or two, that big black and red burn it will go away. I just wanted to leave it up for a little while so that people have a chance to have a really easy method to notify me if they find something that isn't working, so that I can add it to the list of things to fix. Let me make the Twitch feed go away for a minute. You may notice that forums and page toolboxes are now collapsible sections. If you're logged in, it should remember how you had them set up, which ones were collapsed and which ones weren't. So it'll be a lot easier to navigate those, and you can hide the things that you don't need easier. Really, really quiet crew this morning. Looks like we got 7 people currently. Might be up to 9. Oh, wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 viewers, not including myself. Cool. Does anybody have questions for me? Speed running your morning dailies. Awesome. I'll note today for all the people that have been waiting patiently watching the stream. I don't have any turbine point codes to give away this week. With the update of the new store, I'm without codes for a little bit. I'm gonna talk to Cordovan this week and see if maybe I can't get some for next week, or something of that nature. It is certainly something I want to do again, give out turbine codes for participating in and contributing to the stream. But I don't have any codes this week. So, what would we like to work on this week? Let's take a look at recent changes. See if we can get some ideas. All right, so looks like Crew 121's already been working on knocking out a spam bot. I'll have to send him a talk page notice. There's no reason to have this stay in here. So what I'm gonna do is, let me have a second here. Let's open up my admin account here, and we are going to click on the deletion log for a minute. Do you have an example skunk to look at? Firefox streams really, really slow. All right, we'll see if we can find one in just a second here. Let's see here. Apparently my ability to delete log entries is gone. Update 28 named I don't know. Let's see if I can spell items correctly. Noticed some of the item effects are not in red, but are still missing errored. Apparently my stub threshold is too high. I'll have to adjust that. Some of the tables are broken. Good morning, Amraf. So, Skunk, I'm not seeing what you're talking about, that they're not in red but are still missing or errored. They all seem to be working. There are some that are reddish, but that's just because they're marked as stubs. Let me see if I can fix that for me. Let me drop that down to 100 bytes. Good morning, Jibbo, on IRC. Alright, so that takes care of the stub issue. Mouse over effects with blue links, okay. Let's start at the bottom of the page. Spell focus, spell pen, wizardry bonus, orb bonus. Green augment slot, constitution, false life, colorless green, seeker, spot, orange, improved vorpal, shrieking, armor piercing, keen, weapon bonus, range power, double shot, augment, protection. I see we got a space missing there. Fortification, sheltering, green, spell, illusion, enchantment, green, potency, intelligence, enhancement bonus. Not seeing any arrows being thrown. Good afternoon, Amraf. Glad you're here. Let's try update 27. See if there's something here. Some of the item effects of U27 28 loot are not in red but are still missing or errored. Dazing has an issue, it looks like. probably has an issue. Maximum number of loops have been performed. Aha! That one I'll have to look into that. That one will probably need an update from Zeebo. I believe that I remember that we had a maximum loop issue before, and he had to bump it up. But I'll have to look into that. Improved bashing has an error. Alright, we can look at that one. Deception has an error. Okay. So yeah, we can look at those in just a minute. Let's see here. Let me take a look at the tables thing. Absolutely. If you find anything like that that doesn't look like that looks like it's out of place or broken, let me know as quickly as reasonably possible. And I will fix them as best I can. So collectibles table, spells by class. Let's load collectibles. Okay. Now, well, yeah, okay. The tables are formatted, it's just that there's no borders on them. I don't remember if there were borders before. Let's take a look at the source for that page, the wiki source. Good morning, Fezzen, on the IRC chat channel. Alright, let's see here. So apparently my ability to delete revisions is missing. I'll have to add that as well. Close app. Alright, so, and I see that I got a redundant go to editing area here, which I'll have to fix. Alright, so table. Let's see here. Collectibles table header. Well, that makes it easy, doesn't it? We have it in a template. On the edit pages, you'll see that with the upgrade, we have the list of templates seems to be missing. It's not really. It's under this little collapse section, templates used. So you can actually collapse that list if you want to make your page shorter. We also have a new section called Parser Profiling Data, which will give you information about what the page, if there are page errors. It'll tell you your post expand include size, your template argument size, which really don't mean a lot of anything to anybody except for probably me and three other people. Basically, if there's an error that says, you know, template expansion limit exceeded or whatever, then we'd look at expansion depth, argument size, and post expand include size. It's also possible to exceed the expensive parser function count. Not really something most people need to worry about. It's always been available. It's just that before, in order to see it, you had to do a view page source, which is going to take a while to load. It always does. Before, if you wanted to see that information, you had to view the page source and then scroll down near the bottom of the page. And there's a right here. This is where it used to be. So it looks like our loops is already at 250 out of 250. So that's why we're exceeding that, because we've hit the limit. Expensive parser function count 22, expansion depth 23. As long as the first number doesn't meet or exceed the second number, there won't be an issue. You can see how long it took for the parser to make the page. It took 5 seconds to make this page. But yeah, the information's always been there. It's just been harder to find. Now very easy to get to. So it looks like border 0 implies that those tables never had a built border. Cell padding, cell spacing, nothing special there. Let's see here. So we should make this PX. Text align center. I may actually convert some of these to CSS classes and update them later, but for now, we're just going to make them inline. Really don't need any of that. See if I can remember this. I think it's border spacing is the CSS equivalent of that. Category should actually go at the bottom. All right, so save that. Let's see if that fixes our collectibles issue. Not so much, but I don't remember what it looked like before. Not sure where to go with that. I think I'm going to leave that one for somebody else. There's nothing that's actually changed there. What was the other one? The other table? Spells by class. Let's take a look at that one. See if we can see something that's actually like broken. Well, that table is really long. It stretches out over the edge of the page, but that might be just my zoom level. It is. Just my zoom level, it stretches it out. And I only have it zoomed in so that you can see through the stream. Let's see here. Spells by class. I know there's a table for it. Maybe it was you pick a class, like Sorcerer Wizard. Now I see our table of contents is broken here. But I was intending on going through and getting rid of those anyways and putting them right into the table here. Level 1 would be drop down for that. Aha, so that's what you're talking about. What does it look like when I zoom to the normal level? Yeah, things are out of line. They're offset just a little bit from what they should be. Okay. So let's go to the forums real quick. Let's add some bug reports. Subscribe threads. So I can't reply from this account. I'll have to talk to Cordovan about that. I don't know why I can't reply in that thread. But I can do it from my other account. Bug report from DDOwiki talk with T13 episode 5. Some item. Effect templates have maximum loop or expression errors. Some specific tables like spell lists have misaligned. I can't spell, in case you don't know. Icons, and we're gonna copy paste an example. Let's see here. What were some of the what were the templates that were broken? Let's see here. All right, so they're not showing. Any errors? Okay, I see what's going on with those. All right, so what else have we reported here? So that's it so far from the stream. So we're gonna shrink that down for a minute. What other things have you noticed that aren't quite working as you expect them to? Let me zoom back in. Let's see if I can figure this one out. Before I do that, though. I'm going to type in a question mark uselang qqx. All of these system messages have a special page for them, and I want to find out what the special page name is for this line right here, because it's got a double go to editing area, and I want to get rid of this new one on the end. So I'm going to uselang equals qqx. And we've got preview note, continue editing. So if I go to ddowiki.com/page/mw continue dash editing. All right, so I can get rid of that. I can pull this up. Yeah, that's more content than an error, but we'll look at it in a second. Let's see here. link. Needs to be deleted as it causes double to edit area links. And we'll take and remove this URL thing back there. All right, there's that one. All right, so long page hint size. Interesting. So yeah, we've got that. Let's go down and take a look at this. I believe that those are a template. Templates use for spellbook. I think that they're spellbook one. Oh, so we got a spells per level template. Let's open that one up in edit mode. That'll make it easy to do my table of content thing. Good morning, Duck Force 1. Spellbook header, spellbook 1. So yeah, it's spellbook 1 that I'm going to want. Edit link. Let's go back to read on this one. All right, so set bonus entries for U28 yet? That's just because set bonuses haven't been created yet for U28. It's on the to-do list. It's already 9 o'clock now. Not sure if we'll get to it today or not, but feel free to hop on the wiki and add those if you like. Just about anybody is welcome to edit. As to your error messages, bet we had the same issue back in update 17, which is why there's a text-only version of the page. So that may be required for update 27 as well. We'll see. But there's nothing else to do here on update 27 for now. We'll add that to that list there. Call it good. All right, so let's turn this into full page name pound let's fix this while we're at it. Actually, let's just use class center. So this should turn this level thing into a link to the appropriate section. Looks broken there, but once we go back here and we refresh the page, these should all turn into blue links for level 1 to 9. And clicking on level 4 should take you to level 4. So that's working well now. We can actually get rid of this table of contents. While we're doing that, let's scroll down to the edit box here. So we got spellbook 1. right. So I'm guessing it's just the fact that it's using code that isn't, well, it's still supported, but let's clean it up. Style, background color, row color, height, style, width, 3%, text align, center. It may just be that the width isn't enough to contain the 36 by 36 pixel. So we might have to modify that a little bit. Actually, those are all the same except for the top one here. Let's see here. Space, 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 space. Right, so let's see here. Question icon 36 by 36. Show preview. So still not quite right, and it's a padding and size issue. Okay, so, or it might be even be an align issue. Dude, does every row have text align center? All except for one. So let's take this and move it up here. And then dump that and 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 that. And that. And that. Good morning, Daniela. Still doesn't fix it. Okay. Oh, it might. Let's save it and see what happens. I forgot that examples on template pages don't update until you save. Ah, so that fixes that. So we can close this now. Scroll down to the edit box. We no longer need this table of contents. And actually, we need a new template here. We're gonna do this as style equals width 95%. Margin 0px auto. I'm going to leave border 1px on the outside because of the way that that's handled. We're going to do style width 9%. Close style text align center, and we're going to take the second one here because you can't have two style declarations and have them work properly. Move it up there. Now we can copy this, replace this. And this, 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 and then this, and 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 this. And then we're going to take all of this and we're going to cut it right out. And we're going to do spells per level header. I'm going to do a show preview. And it's going to break everything. And you're going to be like, what's he doing? He just broke that table. Doesn't it look horrible? I'm going to click on this template, spells per level header. And we're going to paste all of our templates in there. Reusable table header. And we're going to wrap this in only include. And we're going to scroll to the bottom of this page. And we're going to go spells per level there for a second. And that isn't there, so that's fine. Oh, that's right, we can do that, can't we? We can just do class equals center. All right, so we get that wrapped in only include. Actually, we probably don't need that. Although, let's take a look here. What's that look like? Doesn't look like anything right now, right? We should probably put a forced non-breaking space in that empty spot. All right. Now when we scroll down to the bottom, we do show preview again. Because that template now exists, it should work again. Yay! And now that that's in a template, we can just reuse that over and over. So let's see here. All of those are working. Copy this. Then we're going to save this page. Yes, I am still on the old computer this week. I actually spent a lot of time working on setting up the new computer last night, and I didn't like the way that the resolution on my screen, so I'll have to be making some modifications for that. I expect that I will be using that computer next week. So what we're going to do here is we're actually going to open up Artificer, Bard, Cleric, Druid, Paladin, Ranger, and Warlock in new tabs. We're going to go to recent changes here. We're going to bring this up back up here. This has already been fixed. So, doesn't look like strike through is an option. We're just going to change the color. To a light shade of gray, and we are going to mark this as resolved. So that one's actually already resolved. So we can shrink that. Hey, Edward made an edit to the Kobold's newest ringleader. Some other edits going on here. Traps unlock stuff. Haywire's Foundry. Good stuff. Let's see what Edward changed. To get all 5 stars, don't use the popular shortcut by climbing over the crates. Ah. I guess that's a good tip. Alright, so we're going to edit. edit, 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 edit. And while those load, I am going to take a short 5-minute break to refill my coffee, and I will be right back. And I'm back. So now that all those pages have loaded, let's start at the beginning. Scroll down, scroll down, scroll down, scroll down, scroll down, scroll down, scroll down. Delete this. Ooh, Warlock might not have that table yet. Apparently, Warlock doesn't have a table, so I'm going to leave that one alone for now. Paste. delete, space. I should probably make a template for this as well. Spells per class, total or something. Let's do that actually. Let's go back to Wizard and Sork here, because Warlock doesn't have a table at all yet. Somebody needs to do. I don't know what they have available yet. I haven't actually played Warlock because I'm waiting for the nerfs to all be done on them so that I can just, you know, build my Warlock and not have to worry about changing it for nerfs, and just enjoy it. So let's go like this. And while that's loading, we'll go to Artificer. We don't need this table anymore. We can replace all of this with this. Class sort bottom center. Spells per level. And then we're going to make a spells per level total template. And we're going to put, change all of these into single pipes. Then we're going to take this and we're going to move it up here. And we're going to take all the single digit ones and add a space in front of them. And we're going to add some spaces. I don't like that. Well, maybe. That's why you're going to just had a. So in. Should R read into what you just said? They're gonna nerf Warlock even more. No, I have no idea what they're gonna do with Warlock. I think that they're mostly satisfied with the way that it is, although there may be some things that they nerf a little bit more. It's, as far as that goes, it's just as much a guessing game for me as it is for you most of the time. Very rarely do they run those types of nerfs by us first. We're actually pushing for a little bit of a boost for a couple things, because we think that they over nerfed a couple things, and then there are other parts of it that we think are under-nerfed. Like they cut one thing back from 150% to 130, and we think maybe 120 would be better. They cut one back from 110 to 95%. We think maybe, you know, 105% would be better. But, you know, it is what it is. You had to trash your pally lock because they nerfed Divine Grace. Well, they've been saying for a while that they were going to. Everybody knew it was coming. They declared a couple updates ago that they intended on doing that. In the quest under new ravagement, sometimes the optional locate and kill Vorn doesn't trigger. Even with a full group and lots of AoE, he doesn't show up. How and where do we put this issue up? Edward, you can make a note of it on the wiki, but the best suggestion that I can give you is to visit ddobugs.turbine.com and submit an actual bug report. No, it's not one of those soon TM things. So yeah, ddobugs.turbine.com, and you can also click on any of the links to visit the IRC channel, and Vargwheel, Cookie Cobalt, Steel Star, and NoBob frequent the hashtag DDO channel quite often. This channel right here. And you can pop in and say, are one of you guys around? And, you know, can you take a look at a bug report I just put in about... And the more detail you can give them about the bug, the better. So, yeah. So, if we take and we copy this template, close that, we show preview on this. And yes, it looks broken again for the moment. But we're going to make a new template out of it. We're going to paste this in there. Scroll back down to the bottom. It's going to be class sort bottom center. So the class sort bottom center. The first one is just total. And actually, I want that to be small caps. I want all of these to be bold header style. Well, what did I say for that other template? I don't know. We could dump this though. Oh, wait. I need to copy this. We can dump that. Alright, so we can put this at the end here. What I can do here I think I said reusable table header, only it's going to be table footer. Save page. Use new template. Show preview. We got total there. I think I'll make that big too. but it looks good. And actually, I might make a master template later. And I wanted to edit. I wanted to change this way that this total looked. Right now it's small caps and it's bold. Let's make it big as well. That looks better. All right. So I've got half an hour left. Let's make a new table, a new template. This is going to be a little bit more complex. We're going to make one called Spells Per Level Table. And what we're going to do paste. Paste, delete, 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 delete. And what we're going to do is a show preview. And it's going to be like, what? What's this new template? I don't know what that is. Let's try show preview again. It didn't take the first time. There we go. It's going to be like, what is this spells per level table thing? And what we're going to do is we're going to copy this right here. We're going to need to do some looping in here and use some variables. All right, let's take a look at our actual table here. So our actual table has all of the schools, a total column, which is automatically calculated, and then totals at the bottom, which are manually calculated. You gotta manually calculate all these, and I don't like that. I think this should be automatically calculated just as well as that. So, and I'm gonna have to adjust total up here to match this one, I think. Or, yeah, I should probably make this one match that one. So, what we're gonna do who said something in there. So we got Geoff, which is DDO Gamer. All right, so let's go over here. So we are going to need to use our loops extension. And we're going to do something with it that I don't do very often. So I'm going to have to look at the documentation. You've been meaning to ask for a while. There a reason for the limit on number of maps per quest? Legacy code. That's the only reason. Somebody was going to have to go in and modify the template eventually to be able to allow for more. Before we had the loops extension, each and every map had to be hard-coded in individually. So we took whatever the maximum number of maps being used was, and we physically duplicated the code that many times. So if you have a block of code, right, and you've got five maps, you have that block of code five times. So you end up with a chunk of code. Now that we have the loops extension, somebody's going to be able to go through and take that block of code and put it inside of a loop so that it just keeps running over and over and over again until it runs out. But nobody's done it yet. So we're going to go to fornumargs. And I want the example apricot, caramel, eclair. That's the example I want. So fornum args arg number is going to be level. So no. All right. So we're going to have for num args index 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2. Nope, that goes up a line, and these are all going to get condensed. I'm actually going to show you the process that needs to be done for the maps and quests with this template. It's just going to, right now we have this block of code to present six levels of spells. When I'm done, it's going to be one line of code repeated over and over again. So we got for num index is going to be our index number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 18. So index minus 9. Okay, value is going to be whatever is in there. So the value is going to be count. It's going to be the spell count. The NoWiki thing, I don't think I need that actually. Actually, I think I will. All right, so NoWiki. All right, so what we're going to do, is this first one right here is going to be expression var index mod 9. That will get me. So it needs to be this plus one to get me the actual index. So one mod nine is one. That doesn't work. Nine mod nine is zero. So instead of that, it's going to be 9 minus mod. So 8, 16 mod 9 is 7. What do I want to do here? I want to get numbers 1 through 9 as many times as there are levels. Oh, right. The first one is the level. So I don't even need to use for num args. What I need to do is just a regular loop for 1 to 9. So it's going to be loop. Loop index 1 to 9. Okay, so what I need to do is move this over here. This is not going to be for num args, it's going to be loop index 1 to 9. Drag this over here. All right, so now that I have that, no, that's not right. That only works if there's 9 spells. 9 levels of spell. So this is the fun of building complex templates. You actually have to sit and you have to think about it and process out how it's going to work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Figured something along those lines, but shy away from altering anything too major, even if I did have authorization to do so. I'm not sure what you mean, Skunk. But don't ever be afraid of making changes to anything on the wiki. If you break it, it's real easy to revert it. Ah, the map loops. What you do for that is, let's actually open a new tab for that. What you do for that is you go to Template Quest, right? And actually, I believe, yeah, Template Quest. Here's what you do. You don't have permission to edit it, probably because it's probably fully protected, and I don't think you're an administrator. So, you've got map pick 2, map pick 3, map pick 4, other map, third map, fourth map, fifth map, loading pick, all kinds of funky things. So what you do is you go to View Source. Right? You can look at the source of the page even if you can't edit it. That's fine. You can't edit it. It's fully protected, so you can't actually change the template. So what you need to do is view the source of the page, and you copy everything in View Source. And then you go up here to the URL bar. And you put slash sandbox. And you'll get a page to create a sandbox. So you can't edit it, but you can copy the source code, the wiki text, and then you can create a page called sandbox. And you type in something like start with live template, and you hit save page. All right, so now you have a page that is not protected. That's a template page, sandbox of the quest, right? Exactly the same thing as what's in quest. Now you can go to edit. And you can scroll down. And you can find the map section. So you go down until you find code here, where it says code only include all this stuff, right? That's your starting point. You've got mission box info, and you've got map pick 2, map pick 3, map pick 4, map pick 5, right? And then you've got map legend, other map, third map, fourth map, fifth map, right? Yes, except that you're missing a semicolon between template and quest. And it's case sensitive. So that's what you would need. It is case sensitive. So what you're going to do is you're going to find that those map pictures are actually part of the mission box info. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to leave these alone for legacy historical reasons. But you're going to take this right here and you're going to go four args, right? And you're going to go back over to here to your extension loops, and you're going to look at four args, prefix key value. And your best way to do it is actually to look at the example. This is the code, this is the wiki markup, and that's what it produces. So arg, okay. So arg is what's in the prefix here. So it's going to be the arg is going to be map pick. Over on the end over here, so four args map pick, right? And you're going to go back over here and you're going to see key is going to be whatever the key is for what's on the end. So if you got your map pick here, whatever's on the end. So you can call that index, right? And then you've got, so you got your index, and then you get your value. So you can call that pick. And then you can put in your NoWiki, because you're going to have a line feed. Two, three, four. And you're going to start, well, right at the beginning. And it's going to, because you're inside of a template, you're actually not going to indent here, because of the way that it works. But because you're inside of a template like this, you're going to go like this, and you're going to go map pick var. Index equals map pick var index, right? And you're going to take this and you're going to move it up because four args won't find the one without it and you want it to be backwards compatible. You're going to delete all this. You no longer need it. And you can even take nah, we're not even gonna worry about that. And we're gonna go like this. Unlimited map picks. Before we do that, we're gonna have to go to mission box info, which is also protected. So we're gonna save this. I'm gonna look over here at the source. I'm gonna scroll down here. And this is where the map pictures go. So you're actually gonna end up deprecating these parameters right here. Other map, third map, fourth map, fifth map. They're no longer gonna be needed. So we can go back over here, and because it's a sandbox page, we can actually mess with stuff and not have to worry about it. And we can go down here and we can go, these we no longer need, they're just toggles, so they won't be needed anymore. Won't need toggles, right? Because this will only pass through the parameters that exist. Save page. We go over here. We copy all the source. We go to the end here. We add a sandbox. Paste. Start with live template. Right? We can go back and we have to edit the documentation for this. Before we make an edit request, we should have that taken care of. Other map won't be needed. Third map won't be needed. Fourth map won't be needed. That won't be needed. Map legend. Should actually go up there. You can add as many map pictures as needed by duplicating this line, changing the index to index plus one, which means if it's two, you make it three. If it's three, two, max index, highest index plus one. All right. Update docs. We're going to scroll down here because, okay. So apparently it's not mentioned in the description part itself. So that's good. You now have a mission box info sandbox template that you can edit. Scroll down to the edit box here. Scroll to the bottom. So we have our map pick here. We're going to change this from style to class. We're actually going to go back and edit template quest for a minute because we're just going to reuse our loop. It's going to be the same loop in the other template, basically. So I scroll down here and we're going to do four args index. It's going to be the same chunk of code for this. So you get four args index. And we're going to comment out this old chunk of code for the moment. I'm going to put our close in there. And we're just going to do, so because we're inside, nested inside of a template, we're going to escape all of our pipes and equal sign. So it's going to be pipe equal, and then it's going to be pipe space call span equals two class equals center pipe. We no longer need these switches. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna take the map here. Right, and we're going to paste that in there for a minute. All of this is just duplication of the same code, so we can delete that. We don't need that. We have all the important parts, right? But we need to do a little bit differently here. This is going to be map pick var, and it is index namespace 6. So what we got to do is copy this, next map, because I don't feel like doing the verbose versions of that. I actually think we have a template that does that. Let me check. More options. Simple templates. No. One variable. No. Two variables. No. More variables. No. Template functions. Ah, so we do. We have a deck to Nord. So we can actually delete that. We can actually do decimal number to numeric ordinal, which is going to be var index. Or even better, we can do dec to wcar. Numeric ordinal just means 2nd, 3rd. I'm not sure what wcar does. I'm not sure if it does first, second, third, or if it does 1, 2, 3. I don't remember. But we can play with it. We can make it one or the other. It won't matter. So the index for that. Use a loop to support multiple maps. That might be wrong. I'm not actually passing the value through. Because pick is a value and I'm not using it. So map pick index equals map pick index. I don't know, I'll have to play with it. But basically what we can do here is now we take this, right, and we change sandbox to test cases, and we do a simple quest, right? Only thing is that won't get us our sandbox. So we need to make sure that we do quest slash sandbox and map pick equals, and we're going to do some testing here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going to add 11 in there. And we're just going to pass it nopick.jpg, right? Nopick.jpg doesn't exist. Okay. Maybe it's nopick. Things are case sensitive, and I don't remember what's what for that. Ah, there we go. So we can just take this, right? And we can go paste, 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 paste. And now we should get 11 no picks. I haven't been in game to notice. So we're going to save our test cases page here. We'll actually add some pictures later, but all right, so we got our first one, but the rest aren't working. All right. Name map. All right. So this is mission box info. So yeah, I'll have to play with it a little bit more. It's just a matter of getting the parameters to pass through correctly. So what I think I need to do is go to sandbox and edit. Oh, right. I know what's going on. Our sandbox isn't using our sandbox. So we have mission box info sandbox. All right, so now we should be able to refresh this page and we should be able to see expression error unexpected operator. So we get a little bit of a difficulty here, although no picture did show up. Go down to editing area. So let's copy this. Those are things that could go wrong, so let's save that. Go back here, that's the sandbox. So here's our test case page. And we're actually a few minutes over our 10 o'clock. But we're getting, a bunch more errors now. So we're making progress. Name nopic.jpg, that's working. Expression error unexpected operator. So basically it's going to be that decimal to NORD not being what it's expecting. Because it's not a number. Index should be a number. Let me make one more poke at this. Ah, so it's empty. That's why. Okay. So I'm going to wrap up the stream here. Please, I'm going to continue to work on this and the other template that I was working on for spells per level table. Please get in touch with me somehow to report any bugs that you find on the wiki, things that aren't working as they're are supposed to be. And I will get on fixing them as soon as possible. Let's submit this post real quick at the end of the stream here. Don't forget to catch our Polish friends today at 1 p.m. and the 5 o'clock stream, I believe it is. And I will catch you same shoe channel, same shoe time next week. And have a great week.